today I'm going to talk about convex lens. This is a convex lens. As you can see, it is tapered at the edges and bulged out at the center. This lens is also known as converging lens. Through the diagram, we will see that why this lens is known as a converging lens. Here is a diagram. When you will draw the diagram of a convex lens on the paper, it will be like this. We can see that it is a stack of prism. And as per the property of a prism, when a ray of light enters in a prism, it bends towards its base. So the same thing happened in the convex lens. The rays of light are entering and they are bending towards its base and converge at a point. In the next diagram, we will see that how it happened. You can see these are the parallel rays of light falling on the surface of a lens and they are converging at a point. There is a ray which is going undeviated through the lens. This happens because the rays are falling at 90 degree on this surface. This particular ray is falling at 90 degree on this surface. And at this point, there will be a real, diminished and sharp image formed. In the next diagram, we'll see that how to calculate focal length of a convex lens. I have used a method in which object is at a distance. These are the two parallel rays of light which is falling on the surface and after that they converge at a point. At this point there will be a diminished, sharp and real image will form. The distance between the optical center and this point is known as focal length. Now we'll see through the experiment how this happened. Here I have set up experiment. This is a convex lens and here is a screen and we'll see that a sharp image of the window should form on the screen. We have to adjust the distance. Yes, now it is. So when we look at the scale, here is the scale. This distance is almost 14 centimeter. So this 14 centimeter distance between screen and the convex lens is known as focal length of this convex lens. Thank you.